Yes.
So now I'm asking him, can you explain to us the benefit of having 72 virgins?
No answer. No
can
answer.
You give us the answer now, the camera is here.
Oh, let the camera roll.
Yes.
What I'm asking
you, give
you
us the answer.
Listen, you said all of the things that
he's
you
not answering.
Listen,
you
don't want to
answer. Mansoor, answer the question.
You don't want to listen.
Yeah.
So now, hang on.
So why you mean
all you said in your paradise, I want to read it. Go ahead.
When you tell me.
No,
when you tell me. Sorry.
From your Bible, what you said, what you'll do in paradise.
Yeah.
Right.
So basically, you said you will be with God.
No, Mansoor.
There will be. Wait. Let me recap what
can
you said.
Answer my question.
Let me recap. No, the question I asked you is what you
just said. You get.
You
72 virgins, what do I get?
Exactly.
I told you what I got.
Listen, exactly.
I get
you
to
said,
be with God,
said,
God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit.
That's
said,
it, Mansoor.
I get to be in union and relationship with my Father, my Heavenly Father.
What kind of relationship?
Okay, I get to be in a world where there's no more sin. A father, daughter. Where, exactly. Where there's
no more sexual immorality, right?
Where there's no sexual immorality.
Can I read
where you get a heaven where you're having orgies with 72.
Yes, Mansoor. Shame on you, my friend.
In your crooked mind,
eternal virgins, huri. Get your huris now.
Crooked, evil mind. You have a very much underestimated.
Are you talking about God?
So now,
are you talking about Allah?
You, a seashell Christian group, seashell Christian. Now, sadaqatil and sadaqatil will
decide. Don't panic.
Now, you ready?
Don't change the topic. 72 virgins.
5 minutes.
Stick to your virgins.
I asked you. You said, "Oh, there will be no sexual immorality," and all the things you said. Can you substantiate all of that from your Bible?
After you answer my question,
answer the question, virgin boy.
When you answer my question, I'll answer your question.
Right now.
No. You answer. I answered your question already. You need to answer my question.
Answer the question.
What is the benefit of 72 virgins in heaven?
The question that I ask you.
He's not going to answer your question. He's not going
to
answer your question.
You think she's unable to answer?
No. Don't change. Don't run away, Mansoor. Mansoor, stop running away. He's not going to answer the question. Stop running away with your 72 virgins.
What is that?
You figure it out.
Oh, he's so good at
my fulfillment is different from yours.
Explain what is that.
No, my fulfillment.
Why is it different?
I don't know what that means.
I can't tell you. I keep on asking.
You're going to have sexual organ problems.
No.
Mansoor! Mansoor!
Tell me in detail in your book what would you do in paradise.
Mansoor, you're not denying. You see, he's not denying. Let me get something stupid.
Yes. Stop barking.
I think you didn't understand the English that I spoke.
Because you don't answer the question.
You did not understand the English that I spoke. I did not ask you what would you not do. Hear me out again. I am not asking you what you would not do. I am asking what would you do in paradise. According to the Bible, open up your Bible and tell me what would you do in paradise. Tell me what would you do in paradise according to your text. According to the Bible, what would you do? Any questions here? I don't know the answer. Anyone else?
Answer is your 72 virgins. What are you going to do with 72 virgins? Nobody. 72 virgins. Don't run away, Mansoor. Mansoor. Barking. Don't run away with your 72 virgins. Cut back on your virgins.
Why is that pleasurable?
Why is that something to be
ashamed
of?
You have
both
of me in
my life.
Before
you come back here, do
you have your Bible?
He's afraid.
Answer my question.
He's not going to answer the question. Don't panic. Don't run away with your virgins.
You know what she said? Do you know what she said?
Why don't you talk to her?
Why are you
not
talking to her?
Because you interrupted.
No. Fire exit. Fire exit.
You came late.
Talk to her.
What would intercede, you in paradise. You understand?
It's in the angel.
Do you understand the question?
Living a holy life.
Do you understand?
What was your question? Repeat, he's not answering.
Holy life.
The question I asked her is,
what would you do? Now, I'm asking, what would you do? What is the pleasure of
the Bible? And then, what are you going to do?
Every single Christian says, never answer a question.
Mansoor!
As do you promise?
Where are you running away to?
We are now ready to debate.
There's
no question about this.
He's running away. He's running away. He's running away. He's running away.
Listen.
He's running away.
Question I asked her.
I've been recording for 5 minutes.
The question. The question is.
Stop running away.
And for your life.
No.
Last week,
talk
you lied that there is a hadith which says.
She's asking you the question. Why are you running away? Mansoor, stop running away. Okay, he's running away. He's running away.
There is a word called sadafatin. There is a word called sadafatin. And sadafatin means seashell. Sadafatin means charity. I'm challenging you that it doesn't say that.
Paradise! Don't panic, Mansoor.
I'm not even in your twisting apart. You made a claim that in the Welsh Quran,
your 72 virgins, stop running away from your virgins. Stop running away from your virgins.
You say sorry, I made a mistake. I can take it.
Let me respond. So, I have been recording for 5 minutes, and I'm simply waiting. Very simple answer to the very simple question.
Exactly.
Months.
Oh boy.
You are going
to
become
virgin every time when you visit them. And sister must simply ask him what the
woman is going to get in paradise. Do you know what?
You're talking to her. It's a painful day, I know.
Everything that you said, substantially.
Go ahead.
Everything you said. Let's summarize. I've had it all.
Do you have 72 virgins in heaven? He said, yes. What do you get? Right? So I said, okay, since you seem to be both, can you tell us the benefit of your 72 virgins? So I'm sure you get what we get in heaven. We get
Jesus! Reject Mahmoud.
What do you do?
We get to live in a world without sin. Revelation 21:3 says, behold, the dwelling place of God is with man. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people, and God himself. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes. And death shall be no more. Neither shall there be any mourning, no crying, no cool, no pain.
In 5 minutes, half a million people.
Exactly. So answer the question. Answer the question, Mansoor. Don't run away.
You would not have any physical
pleasures. What is the benefit of it?
No,
are you saying in your...
Stop running away.
Only one. When you wipe your tears of your eyes, is that physical?
What is the benefit?
Never say sorry.
Excuse me, don't interrupt me. Listen, when... Wait, wait, shut up. Now, I want to demonstrate to you, Christians do not read or understand the text properly.
Stop panicking. Don't panic. Look, I understand. It's a very painful day for you.
He will wipe away every tear from your eye. Is that physical?
Is that physical?
Is this physical?
There's no huris in paradise.
I am answering. Okay. So now you have tears and eyes. Would you have tears and eyes?
That's better than having
orgies with somebody. It's not better or not.
Oh. Huri time!
Listen. So in heaven, you'll have a physical body, and you'll have eyes, and you'll have no tears.
He's digging himself some pictures.
Wait. What we establish is this. Minimum. So you have a physical body. Hang on. So you have a physical body where you'll not be crying. You'll have a body, but you'll not feel pain. So you have a physical body, right? Would you experience physical pleasure?
Yes,
it's God, still use God.
Physical. Would you, let me repeat my question again, perhaps you didn't hear it. Would we don't listen.
Would Christians, listen.
Would you experience physical pleasure in paradise according to the text that you've read?
Not sexual. So the answer is yes.
Okay.
Can you answer?
Answer the question. 72 huris.
Slow down. So you have a physical body, and you'll experience physical pleasure. Now, how does a physical body experience physical pleasure? Go ahead.
You tell us.
He's digging himself in some pit.
Now, I am exposing your hypocrisy.
No, right? Oh, is it?
In your belief system.
You haven't answered the question. You haven't answered the question.
In your text.
72 virgins. Mansoor, tell us.
In Islam, the heaven that you believe in,
yes,
there will be no sin.
Oh.
So did you?
Hooties!
Is sleeping with your husband a sin?
Slow down!
If your husband have two, three wives,
he's not answering the question.
Is that a sin?
He's not answering the question.
That's not what I asked you.
He's not answering the question.
That's not what I asked you.
So you need to explain.
That's not what I asked you.
Can you handle 72?
Did you hear what I said?
Can you handle 72?
Now, good question. Interesting deflection, right? I asked you.
Answer the question.
Listen, if your husband married another wife, listen. If your husband had co-wives like your prophets did in the Old Testament, is that a sin?
Not then.
He's not answering your question.
He's not answering your question. What is the answer? So if your husband have another wife,
He's running away.
Are you saying the prophets that had many wives? How many wives did Abraham have?
No, question is 72 virgins.
Christians are so suffering from inferiority complexity. What you are saying is this. If your prophets, like Abraham and Solomon, if they had many wives and co-wives,
answer the question.
Sin in the sight of God.
Answer the question. How much you do virgin?
Is this a sin?
He's not going to answer the question.
Oh, I'm not going to answer the question.
Bye-bye.